Welcome to the Slide Gettin's Tech Simplified channel. And if you're planning to take the MS-500, the Microsoft 365 administration exam, you're going to want to watch this video to the end. Knowledge is king. I passed the exam on May 16, 2020. I'm excited. I'm feeling great. You see the balloons, the confetti coming down, right? Don't you want that feeling? If you keep watching this video, you will get that feeling. Trust me. But it will take time. It took me about 40 hours of studying time. So just keep that in mind. But you want to keep watching this video to the end because I'm going to lay out how I pass. The MS-500 gauges your ability to manage identity access management, threat protection, information protection, and lastly, governance and compliance. So if you can do that, this exam is definitely for you. So who will benefit from passing this exam? Well, if your day-to-day activities include MFA, conditional access, or identity access management, this will be a great video for you and an exam for you to take. If you deploy threat detection like Windows Defender in your environment or leverage an Intune with Windows Defender, this video and this training is for you. And also, if you work with information protection and governance and compliance in your environment, this exam and video is for you. So let's go into what you actually need to do to prepare for this exam and what resources that I leverage to pass this certification. So let's go. First resource I have to cover is the Microsoft website. This website is a great place to find a lot of the information that you're going to leverage throughout your studying and also on the day of the test. So the first thing I need to talk about is it shows you what the test is going to be about, any key information that you need to know prior to the test, who's the right person to take this test. And one thing I need to point out that's a little bit different with this outline is on June 8th, 2020, they will be updating the exam. So Microsoft is going to be updating it on June 8th. So if you're watching this after that, make sure you take a look at the outline to see what changed, because what I'm covering today is still going to help you probably 90% of the way, that 10%, see where the changes are, see where it overlaps, and then you can make your studying arrangements after that. So the first thing to talk about is how much does it cost, right? So it costs $165. That might seem like a lot, but if you take a lot of exams, you know that's pretty cheap. Great thing is, if you're employed right now, your company probably would pay for it. If they don't, I still think it's a great certification to have, and it can help you increase your pay. So if you're unemployed and you're trying to make yourself in the best version of yourself before you apply for your next job, pay the $165, because I'm telling you, you'll probably have an increase in your pay just for having a certification. So the next thing is you can do it is schedule your exam on this page. And the skills measure piece, we're going to talk about that later because that's going to provide you with the outline. Microsoft does give you some free training. This free training is not enough to study and pass for this exam. It's a good place to start, but it's not enough to pass for the exam. You can pay for instructor-led training. My company, Ingram Micro, actually has ingrammicrotraining.com, and I use their training, and I did use a four-day training class that helped me prepare for it. If you do want to pay for it, you can find this on your own. So the next thing we're going to talk about is some of the exam policies. So one thing that's unique in this time frame, as you all know, with COVID-19, is we're home. So a lot of the testing centers are closed. Depending on what state you are, they might have opened up. At least I know in New York, they're not open up. I took my test at home, and it actually was pretty cool. It was a little bit challenging because I had to make sure to cover all my second and third monitors up. I had to clear my desk off, take certain things off. It's a little bit challenging, but for the most part, I'd rather be at home. I can control the temperature. I can control the look and feel. It was easy. I still passed the exam, so I felt like I can control that environment. If you don't have a separate area for the test and you're worried about someone walking in, you might want to wait till the test center near you opens up, because if someone walks in, you will fail that exam. So the next thing that I do want to talk about is the actual study guideline that Microsoft provides. It's pretty solid. One thing I wish Microsoft would do would add the links to the document pages. So if Microsoft, if you actually watch this video, just add the links for us. Instead of us have to go find it and create the links, just add them in there. You know, you want us to pass this test, right? So just add them in there. So the great thing is I leverage this cheat sheet, but I found a way to put it in Asana, and I also leverage OneNote to organize my thoughts. I'm gonna share those with you so you can pass this exam. But you can leverage this so you can see what's gonna be on the exam, what you already know, what you need to study, and focus on those areas, right? It helped me tremendously. So one thing I do wanna show you is on June 8th, they updated. Great thing about Microsoft, what they did is show you what changed. What did they take out? What did they add in? What's some additional things that they did to change it? As you can see, they did do a lot of upgrading to the Office 365 ATP. It took a lot of stuff out, but they did add in some information about Azure for Sentinel. You can see the updates. I'm not here to tell you everything, so spend some time if you're planning to take it after June 8th to review that page. One thing that I did is I took the skills measure document from Microsoft and put hyperlinks to those sections. Again, this is for the test prior to June 8th. I haven't made those updates to reflect. So if anyone wants to go ahead and do that, let me know and I'll update the document. So one thing you will find in here, you're gonna see the key tenets of the exam, the percentages you're gonna need to pass. Also, that free training, I put the link there for you, the measure up practice test questions. I use that, they are absolutely phenomenal. It helped me with the transition into the testing, same type of environment, same look and feel, the answers were all correct. So that's one thing I can't stress enough. If you have the money to pay the 110, I think it was, I think they got a 30% discount going on, look for that. Use it, it definitely helped me. I passed it on the first try. If you're a little bit more traditional of a person, like to read books, go ahead and buy that book there. I did not use it. I used the hyperlinks below to prepare. So when you click on these links, it's gonna take you to the Microsoft documentation page that talks about that certain information. So again, it's not for me, it's for Microsoft, and these links will help you pass the exam. So the next thing I'm gonna show you is how I leverage Asana to block out my time to prepare for this exam. So I leveraged Asana about the last 2 weeks in preparation for the exam so I could really maximize my time. Being a dad and a husband, you know, I gotta dedicate time to the family. So I had to make sure that I'm maximizing my time early in the morning, in the evenings, without, you know, overstepping those boundaries. So I leverage Asana, I use it usually during my day to make sure I'm on task. So this helped me a lot preparing for it. If you can start off with doing this, it will save you so much time. And the good thing about it, Asana is free for one user, so just sign up for it. So the first thing I did is, all right, let's take that skills measure document and create subcategories and the main category for it. So for implementing, managing identity access, I created all these sublets. With inside these subcategories, I created all the hyperlinks that I had in there within those subcategories. So I made deadlines for it, so I had to read them before I proceed to the next area. This was great because one thing it helped me do, it helped me keep on schedule. It showed me where I was currently at. And what I end up doing is, I deleted it here, is I would write complete or done. I would say done. So then I would know that I was done with that section just in case I got carried away or my wife needed me or I had to do something else in that time. I knew where I was at the end of it. Very helpful tool. You can even, if you got a study buddy, if it's multiple people taking it in your organization, tag them in it. You might have to pay a little bit more if you want to get some other people in there, but it's a really helpful tool if you haven't used it. And then once you're all done, all you have to do is mark it complete, and then you see the check mark. And when you're done all of them, mark it complete. And then if you go into the threat detection, now you're gonna see the subsections that I created there. If you click on details, you'll see all the different subsections of it and all the subtasks as well. Right, so, and then when I'm done, I just clicked here. And I did that all the way until I got to my practice test. And then one for my practice test to make sure that I knew what areas I was solid in and what areas I wasn't solid in, I went to OneNote and created and tracked every single practice test that I leveraged. So I'm gonna share you some really embarrassing scores, so don't judge me. Just know I passed this test on the first time, but if you get a really bad score on that measure up test on the first time, don't be alarmed, because when you see my practice test, it was pretty bad. As you can see on my first time, I scored 36 out of 80%, right? Like I needed 80% to pass, right? I got a 36 on the first time. I got a zero on managing information protection. Why? I never really had to talk about it at work. So that was an area that I already knew I needed to spend my time. So what did I do next? I created my priority list, right? So I saw I got a zero on that that first one. I made that my number two priority. Why? Just because governance and compliance takes up a bigger chunk or percentage for that test. So I needed to know that, and I only got a 16% on that, right? So that's one thing I had to know. My last test, I end up getting 100% on the information protection piece. So you can see I went from 0 to 100 by my last one. Ended up getting a 63% where I had a 29% or a 16% on that first one. And then you can see on my other areas, I didn't do too well. But as you can see on different ones, on this one, I had 100% on it again, a 90% on threat detection, and a 47% and a 20%. And the 20% was so low, it was a lot of PowerShell questions that I did not understand. So if you're not comfortable with PowerShell, I would tell you to make sure you brush up on those skill sets, right? So there's a really good LinkedIn training that I use that I'll link into the bottom in the description, where it went over the high level on how to construct the PowerShell statement and the key to way to read the syntax. That helped me tremendously on the test. Even though I never implemented it, I could read and understand what the statement was telling me, right? So that's one thing that I definitely suggest you do. And as you can see on my right-hand side, I leverage this for all my certifications. So the next certification I'm taking is the Azure 500 security certification, and I'll be doing the same. So organization, the key. The tool doesn't matter. If you use OneNote, great. If you use Evernote, fine. If you use something else, it does not matter. Just make sure you're tracking your time, you're tracking how you're passing these exams. So I can't stress that enough. Go in there before you start studying. Take your first test, see how you do. Then see what you know or what you perceive you thought you knew, and then compare that to what you need to do to pass that exam. It helped me tremendously for me to pass this test on the first time. All right, so if you want that study guide, this is what you have to do. So listen closely. If you're new to my channel, go ahead and subscribe and like this video and add me on LinkedIn. And within the LinkedIn message, let me know that you want that MS-500 study guide. If you already subscribed to my channel, make sure you still like this video, but also share it on your LinkedIn profile and tag me in it. Send me a private message after you do that and ask me for the study guide, and it's all yours. You made it to the end. Thank you for your time. The next video drops next Monday. So how do you know when this video comes out? Subscribe and click the bell to stay notified. But the learning doesn't stop today. Continue to watch other videos during my channel where I talk about Microsoft security, other tech careers, and how to thrive during this quarantine time. So until next time, Sly Gittins is out.